Today we shall start a new chapter, radiation. Radiation under model 4. So first we shall define some of the basic terms associated with radiation. Now first we'll go to the first reflection, absorption and transmission of radiation. So here you can see if QI is the amount of energy incident upon a body, then part of QI is absorbed, part of incident radiation QI is transmitted and part of QI is reflected. The ratio of amount of energy absorbed to the amount of energy incident is known as the absorptivity, and ratio of total energy reflected divided by amount of energy incident is known as the reflectivity, and total amount of energy transmitted, ratio of ratio of energy transmitted to the amount into the incident energy is known as transmissivity. Therefore, QI should be equal to QA plus QR plus QT. So QA by QI plus QR by QI plus QT by QI equal to 1. So alpha, therefore QA by QI equal to alpha, QR by QI equal to reflectivity, and QT by QI equal to transmissivity. Therefore, alpha plus reflectivity plus transmissivity equal to 1. Now, opaque body. What is opaque body? Opaque body is one which does not transmit any radiation. Opaque body is that which does not transmit any radiation. So, for opaque body, transmissivity equal to 0. Transmittivity equal to 0, then alpha plus r equal to 1. So all bodies considered in the radiation chapter are considered to be opaque bodies. Then black body. So if all energy incident on the body is observed, whatever the energy is incident upon a body, whole amount of energy is absorbed by the body, QI equal to QA, QI equal to QA, alpha equal to 1. Therefore, alpha will become to equal to 1. Black body is 1, whose absorptivity equal to 1. Then white body. If all the energy falling on a body, is reflected, then QI equal to QR, QI equal to QR, then R equal to 1, reflectivity equal to 1. Therefore, white body is that whose reflectivity equal to 1. Then transparent body, if all the amount of energy incident upon a body is transmitted, all the amount of energy incident upon a body is transmitted, then QI equal to QT, QI equal to QT, then transmittivity equal to 1. So a transparent body is that body is one whose transmissivity equal to 1. Example of a transparent body is glass. Glass is an example of a transparent body. Now, reflection, specular reflection, diffused reflection. There are two types of reflection, specular reflection and a diffused reflection. What is specular reflection? Specular reflection is that where the angle of incidence alpha 1 is equal to angle of reflection beta 2. Angle of incidence beta 1 is equal to angle of incidence reflection beta 2, then it is called a specular reflection. It occurs on a highly polished surface. So then diffused reflection. What is diffused reflection? So diffused reflection occurs on a rough surface. When a ray of light incident on a surface is reflected in all the directions, then it is called a diffused reflection. Now, No, emission, next term associated is emission of radiation, total hemispherical emissive power and monochromatic hemispherical emissive power. What is emission? So any body at a high temperature, very high temperature of the order of 1000 Kelvin will emit energy in the form of electromagnetic waves. Will emit energy in the form of any body at a high temperature. Will emit energy in the form of electromagnetic waves. So this process of emitting the energy is known as emission. Then emissive power. Amount of energy emitted by a body per unit time. Amount of energy emitted by a body per unit time per unit area is known as emissive power. Then monochromatic hemispherical emissive power. What is monochromatic hemispherical emissive power? So you can see here, energy is emitted by a body of all the wavelengths, lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, lambda 4, again lambda 1. So energy is emitted by a body of all wavelengths. Energy emitted by a body of a particular wavelength is known as a monochromatic hemispherical emissive power. So watt, it is indicated by watt per, it is expressed as watt per meter square mu m. So mu m indicates the wavelength. So energy emitted by the body of a particular wavelength is known as monochromatic emissive power. Suppose I want to express energy emitted by a body of 5 meter square wavelength, then I should write y divided by per meter square mu 5 mu m. So this is the energy emitted by a body of 5 mu m wavelength. So it is a monochromatic hemispherical emissive power. Now you can see in the figure that here monochromatic emissive power of a body is varying with respect to wavelength. So it increases up to a certain wavelength of a certain value of lambda, and then it decreases. It increases up to a certain wavelength and becomes maximum here and then decreases. So total emissive power emitted by a body is sum of all such all monochromatic emissive powers emitted from 0 to infinity. It is 0 to infinity here, yes, sorry, 0 to infinity. So energy, total energy emitted by a body or a total emissive power is equal to 0 to infinity of Eb lambda d lambda. So it is addition of all emissive powers from 0 to infinity. It is called as a total emissive power. total hemispherical emissive power. I told you, total hemispherical emissive power indicates the energy emitted by a body. Total emissive power is a summation of all the emissive power. Energy emitted by a body of all wavelengths. Therefore, you take a using word total here. Hemispherical shows that energy emitted by a body in all directions. Therefore, total hemispherical word is used. So these are some of the terms associated with